Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and those who have faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the Honorable Presbytery, the Diaconate in Christ, all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their great release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and every city and countryside, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our president, civil authorities, and armed forces, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, Connor, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For helpful seasons, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Called into remembrance our all holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, Lady of the Almighty, and ever Virgin Mary. Pray for all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other, and all our lives, unto Christ our God.
Majesty.
of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and into ages, all ages.
Blessed are the poor in spirit.
us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Holy art thou, our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever,
and unto ages of ages.
Before God, but the doers of the law who will be justified. When Gentiles who have not the law do by nature what the law requires, they are a law to themselves, even though they do not have the law. They show that what the law requires is written on their hearts, while their conscience also bears witness, and their conflicting thoughts accuse or perhaps excuse them on that day, when according to my gospel, God judges the secrets of men by Christ Jesus.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
And to thy spirit.
According to Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
Let us attend.
At that time, Jesus was walking by the Sea of Galilee. He saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And he said unto them, Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, in the boat with Zebedee their father, mending their nets, and he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. And he went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing every disease and every infirmity among the people.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. In the year 1080, Emperor Nikephorius of Constantinople had finished building his cathedral. It took a very long time to build. And he invited three patriarchs, 40 metropolitans, and literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of priests, in addition to the people, to come for the consecration of this cathedral. As people came, maybe a week or so before, they were coming in oxen, horse-drawn carriages, they were walking any way they could get there. And they were filled, were pulling carts that were filled with all the gifts that people were giving to the cathedral. There was wine, there were carpets, there were candles, there was just many gifts. And walking along the road one day, there was a woman whose name was Anastasius. And Anastasius was an old widow lady who was very, very poor. All she really had to her name, aside from the real dilapidated shack that she lived in, was one pitchfork and a sickle. And that was it. And yet, being a pious woman and a woman of faith, she wanted to bring something, just like the other people who were coming from all over. She wanted to bring something as a gift for the cathedral. What could she do? Well, she was walking along. She thought of the oxen. She thought, well, maybe some of the wild grass that grows around Constantinople. If I could cut it, if I could cut some, I could take it to where they were keeping the oxen. And they can be fed. And this is the best I can do. It was very sad. She wanted to do more, but this was really it. And so that is what she did. She took her sickle, she took her pitchfork, and she cut the grass. And took it as a gift and fed the oxen as best she could that were gathered around the cathedral. Well, one day, the day before the consecration was going to occur, the emperor with several of the patriarchs, came in to the church, the cathedral, to just give an inspection, to see how things were. And as they got in there, they saw that everything was looking pretty good. And he looked up on the wall above the entry and took great admiration and seen the plaque that had been placed. That this cathedral was dedicated to the Holy Trinity, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, by me, the Emperor, Victorious. Well, they went, finished their work, went on their way, and then, a little later in the day, as people were coming into the church to just enjoy it, if you will, before the big day of consecration, they noticed that something had changed on the plaque. Instead of saying, given by me, Emperor Victorious, it was changed to given by me, the widow Anastasius. Well, people were frightened. They thought, first of all, we are not sure how this happened, but the emperor is going to be not too happy that somebody has changed the plaque. So instead of getting the emperor, somebody went and got his chief of staff, who came to look at it. And as a big surprise to everybody, he looked up, and instead of getting mad, he said, oh my goodness, this is a miracle. An angel has come and touched the plaque and changed it. But who is this Anastasia? Well, he went and he got the emperor, and the emperor as well was impressed and pleased. He wasn't angry at all, because he recognized a miracle when he saw one. But he wanted to find this person, this widow. He wanted to know who she was. He wanted to meet her. So they finally found her. She was in a corner somewhere in the cathedral. She was praying to God. And so the emperor had her brought to him and pointed out the plaque. And she, of course, was frightened. And yet, once again, the emperor calmed her heart and said, don't worry. This is a beautiful thing. I wanted it for myself. I was taking great pride in this. And now I see that it was a big mistake for me to do that. But God has honored you. Tell me, what was your gift? What was it that you brought that impressed God so much that he sent an angel to change the plaque in your name and in your honor? Well, she reluctantly told him it was a stack of wild grass that I cut off some of the fields around the cathedral. Well, the emperor was incredibly moved by the act of this woman, her sincerity, her piety, her faithfulness, that he wanted to honor her in some way. And so what he promised her was that when she died, she would be buried in the altar at the great cathedral as her reward. And that, my brethren, is the moral of the story. It's a separate story, it's a separate moral. God rewards, because he is so filled with joy, when someone with great sincerity gives to his holy temple, to his church, from such a place of humility, that his joy, God's joy, overflows and he shares it with that person. And he shares it in a disproportional way, a way above and beyond what you think somebody who gave a sack of wild grass should have. But it is only God who sees the hearts of his people and those who love him. And he understands and he appreciates. He has joy and he shares that joy. And this, my dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, is the moral of the story. May God help us to imitate this poor widow lady in what we give in our tithes and offerings to his church, that we too would become like her. That even if all we have is figuratively speaking, some wild grass, that we give what we have. And we will be blessed by God, just as this widow lady was blessed. Above and beyond, disproportionately to that small amount that maybe we were embarrassed at. Maybe we thought it wasn't even worth writing it, in our case, writing a check for. We're bringing to the church. God honors such things. You know, it's incumbent upon us as Christians to factor God into our lives. It's incumbent that we learn to live with God. And in so doing, as in the life of this woman, God shares his joy, and his joy becomes ours. I don't know what could be much better than that. May God bless us and help us to imitate this lovely one.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
is now and ever and unto ages of ages. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for Christine, Miguel, and their newborn, for Sam, for Bill, for Lisa, family, for the Wynn family, for the Dillon family, Gurielin, the Archpriest Wayne, for Anna, Gary, Nava, Serena, for Jared and Destiny, for Lauren, Laurie, Stephanie, Kelsey, Caitlin, Michelle, Christina, Claire, Taylor, and for the sisters of the Nativity of the Theotokos Monastery. May they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the nearly departed Metropolitan Antonios, and for our, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
commit ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Through the compassions of thy only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thy all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages, all ages.
We may confess.
Thousands of archangels and thousands of angels, The cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shall be proclaiming and saying,
I'm not.
To the friends of our holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth. Be mindful, O Lord, of the city in which we dwell, and of every city and countryside, and those of faith who dwell therein. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who travel by sea, by land, by air, of the sick, the suffering, captives, and their salvation. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit and do good works in thy holy churches, and who remember the poor. And upon us all, send forth thy mercy. Grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise thine all honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Mercies of a great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And our God, who loveth mankind, receiving them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us to return his divine grace. And the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Holy things are for the holy.
Neither will I give thee a kiss after Judas, but like a thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy humor. God is judgment, Lord is condemnation. Be my partaking of thy holy mysteries, O Lord. Let us be healing the soul and body.
Prismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church who prepared themselves through prayer and fasting to partake of the sacrament. For those who are not Orthodox, we ask that you refrain from this cup, but that we have some blessed bread to share with you at the end of the service. It is not a sacrament, but it is blessed, and we share it with all our visitors. Join us then.
With the fear of God and with faith and love, draw near.
Thank you. God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Grace and love towards mankind.
to God, through the intercessions of His all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, of the holy glorious and all honorable apostles, of the holy glorious and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, of the holy martyrs Leontios, Hypatios, and Theodulus at Tripoli and Phoenicia, the venerable Leontios the Hagarite, of the Dionysio Monastery on Athens, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as He is good and loves mankind. The prayers of our holy fathers, through Jesus Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
Having concluded the liturgy, we are now going to have our brief memorials, or monthly memorial for those of our family and friends who passed away during the month of June. So, those participating.
Of God,
the Metropolitan Antonios, for Jacob, Megan, Marion, Juan, Paul, Mildred, Douglas, Arnold, Millie, Bill, Dan, Phoebe, the Monk John, Bill, Gabriel, Robert, Melba, John, Roland, Josh, Don, and Daniel, depart this life, and that thou wilt pardon their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary. That the Lord God will establish their souls where their just repose.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
The mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and forgiveness of their sins, let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God.
Lord,
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, do thou the same, Lord, give rest to the soul of thy departed servants, the Metropolitan Antonios, for Jacob, Megan, Marion, Juan, Paul, Mildred, Douglas, Arnold, Millie, Bill, Danny, Phoebe, the Monk John, Bill, Gabriel, Robert, Melba, John, Roland, Josh, Don, and Daniel, in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is through all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, thy all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. In his holy mansions, and number them among the just, and have mercy upon us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. May thy memory be eternal, O our ever memorable brethren, who art worthy of blessedness.
to those visiting with us today, I invite you to join us in just a few moments to the fellowship hall for some coffee and some cake. There are a couple of important announcements to make today. 12:30, clergy, chanting leader, choir leader. We need to meet in here to go over rubrics for the services next Saturday and Sunday. I'm hoping it's a brief meeting. I like brief. Next Saturday and next Sunday, we are actually going to celebrate history together. We've never had anyone from our parish ordained into the priesthood here. And next weekend, we're going to have two, Deacon John Valdez and Deacon Andrew Irene. Deacon John on Saturday morning, Deacon Andrew on Sunday morning, and it'll be Bishop, His Grace Bishop Nicholas, who's actually stationed at headquarters back in New Jersey, who will be joining us and performing those ordinations. It's a big, big, important event for us. So I invite everybody to come, and we'll have plenty of visitors. And what we'll probably be doing is removing some chairs to make room, okay? So give that a thought. It might be good if you want a chair to come here a little bit early, but we think we can fit more in with a few chairs missing that the staff chairs in. But we'll see. We'll see. It'll be a surprise, okay? Also, it's been a long time since we've experienced having a hierarchical liturgy here. And so some, I'm not even sure I've ever seen one. Okay. Very beautiful experience. One thing I want to mention is that when we have the meal, we have a meal on Sunday. Saturday will be a light refreshments. But on Sunday, we'll be all seated, nobody at table with the bishop there and all that. The meal's not over until the bishop is finished, okay? That's the way our tradition works. And he will say the prayer at the end of the meal. So if you have to leave early or go do whatever, that's fine, bear in mind. And he stands up when he prays. It's over. So anyway, I hope that everybody can make it. It's going to be a joyous, wonderful time. The schedule for this coming week remains the same on Wednesday night for both Placentia and Costa Mesa for Vespers. So all the other details of the information and items are in the bulletin. So there you have it.
What's the occasion for the cake?
Well, thanks, Armin. I was going to say something in the fellowship hall, but I can say it now. I always appreciate help.
You can still surprise us.
Okay. The occasion for the cake, so we won't have to say it in the hall now, is Sam Braun is going to Huntsville, Alabama, where he's taking a job with Boeing. He's in procurement, and so he'll be leaving us in a day or two to take a job there. The Wins and the Dillons will be leaving very soon to go to St. Vladimir Seminary in New York, where both Jared and Chris will be studying for the Holy Priesthood. So we have four bright young men in seminary, which another, by the way, that's another first. That's a big deal as well. We mustn't miss that. Also, I think one of the more interesting situations, Bill Moose, Lisa and their children are moving to Hawaii. where they bought a macadamia branch. So every time you buy a can of macadamia nuts in the future, you can always thank the Moosas for their good work. But they'll be moving there very, very soon as well. And we're going to miss them, but we wish them well. And we hope that we get a chance to visit them. I'm willing to go. I'm willing to go and visit them. So anyway. I think those are the ones. Did I miss it? I think I did.
Happy Father's Day.
Oh, yeah. Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. Father. Okay. That's all right.
Thank you.
Of ages.